Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. So this is going to be a vlog of, I looked at a weird camera voice, like, am I okay? Of Mutiny. So I had a spray tan, had my eyebrows tinted, I got my spray tan done by Glow with Alex. I'll leave her Facebook page link down below if you want to check it out. She always does it so well, and it's very natural, like, you just look like you've been on holiday. Like, you might not think it right now on camera, I don't know how it's coming across. But yeah, and then Becky also tinted my eyebrows.
So much room.
Literally, look at how close we are to the fucking toilet.
Our tent, look at that.
Fucking
oh my god.
There's so much room. Look at how much fucking room we've got in our tent. You can't even see it, Courtney. Done well or done well? Thanks,
oh
Shelley.
My god.
Thanks, Shelley, babe.
Literally, the toilet's amazing.
Don't get my
head. Yeah, we love a good Sainsbury's shop, lads.
These were £1.
Get them. That's going straight in my mouth. Get a no, you're
going
to say that.
Straight in my mouth.
Courtney, I know it's really old, but the floor is lava.
Look what I've just found. So that's a normal Barbie. Me and Abby, we're just shopping in Sainsbury's and we find a plus size Barbie.
I think that's so good.
That is so good.
Let me put my sesh goggles on.
Hi guys, we're awake and it's day one. I look like shit, so I've got glasses on. We're literally going to Costa because we feel like death, and I need a wee, and I refuse to use the toilets there because
they're
literally blocked. Disgusting. People have gotten in the shower and pissing. We did glitter. People are looking at us. And we're going to the coach. Courtney's got her hat on.
My sunglasses are from French Connection. My jacket is from Amazon. My play suit's from H&M. This is from Victoria's Secret. My shoes are from New Look. And my socks from Sainsbury's that we bought last night.
Oh.
My sunglasses are from Wish. And my necklace is from Vivienne Westwood. This like bandeau, it's from Topshop. These shorts are from New Look. I got Doc Martin boots and a little bum bag from Victoria's Secret.
Which is the first one, it doesn't go to 11, it's 22. But I'm literally loving how we look right now. I'm so excited to see everyone, and I'm literally buzzing, but we're gonna get some photos over there, I think, because it looks like really, really cool. I really want to do that video. It's called, will you help me out with it one day? It's called taking photo, no, like ugly photo shoot challenge, like ugly places.
Oh my god, should I get one against the tree now?
A tree.
We made it!
We made it!
And look at that, and the fucking portaloo, there's a used fucking
portaloo. Man, this gal is getting boring. Just getting started, all these tinsel lights falling. Yeah, we came up from the dust and I'm getting steady boring. I got some brothers that are living me. They gon' tell us funny shit with me.
Who knows it?
God's plan.
What is she up to?
She said, do you love me? I tell her only partly. I only love my bed and my mom. I'm sorry. Thinking of it. I'm loving with nobody.
All the songs, all the hate on Twitter I've been getting. I just want to. Oh, this is a bit too. So we're going to dim the mood a bit. Don't worry, we'll get it back up. Cool. Let's go. This is called Trapped, yeah? This is going to work.
Saturday, 12 for me.
So you vibe a lot with feeling this.
2-3.
Take everything. Hey, who's dashing to expect?
The ones who turn the studio. Cool.
Take everything in, yeah? Look.
I can tell when someone's jealous of me. The evil look in their eyes. They won't support you if they feel like you're above them. The only reason why they don't want to see you shine. I see a lot of things on my timeline. People think I'm here for a short period of time. If you think that's true, then you're losing your mind.
Let's go.
Yeah!
sorry, bro. I can rule that one up, hold on. You guys are gonna make me cry. Hey, Paul, if you guys don't understand, you're like, nah, let's run it, man. Let's run it, man. Let's do this. Hey, let's do this, guys. Everyone.
I might let my team from locking. She's calling. I'm yawning. She's calling. I might leave my team from walking. 7 a.m. in the morning. She's gone.
Embrace. Space. Space. Hey. Ain't no point in playing it safe. Gotta know your role, better state your case. When it all falls out, better know your place. What? Just for the 3 feet and the outside. Space. 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 You should wanna embrace space. Okay. Coast, coast, coast. Wanna get close on the coast. Coast, coast.
Let's hear it, Are you deaf?
Look at the floor. It's the second day, but it got cancelled because sadly two people died. So yeah, it's been cancelled, but obviously we understand why. We just hope we get a refund. But yeah, so we're going home.
Yay. First thing, I'm just going to say, I think that Mutiny, this is like the truth about Mutiny, I guess, being cancelled. The security did not check our bags enough. They peeked in the bags, didn't look in it properly. It was not good enough. So the security definitely needs to be upped if they're going to do it again. It just wasn't good enough. Fact. There was one sniff a dog for thousands of people. It's not really going to work out, is it? Basically, it sounds awful, but I do blame the people that brought the drugs in and took the drugs more than Mutiny. Because those people made a conscious decision to take the drugs. Those people made a conscious decision to bring the drugs in, to sell them, to give them out. You know, just think about it. If you're in the street and someone came up to you and offered you a pill, would you take it? Probably not. So I'd take it at a festival. It just doesn't make sense to me. But, you know, this is, I hope, to be a lesson learned. Very sadly, three people passed away. One of them was an 18-year-old girl called Georgia. And the drug, she took two pills, which resulted in her blood going acidic, her lungs filling with blood. She had a 45-minute fit. Her muscles broke down, couldn't deal with it, because 45 minutes to fit in a long time. Her blood went acidic, filled with blood, lungs filled with blood, and she sadly passed away. From 18 years old, you know, that could have been me, that could have been you, that could have been anyone, just not one decision. And I think as well, with drugs, it's very risky. You don't know your limits. You know, a 20-year-old man died as well, another gentleman died, and 8 people were in hospital, was the last report. And for me, it's like, you don't know your limits. I know a girl at the festival that took 5 pills and was fine, and that girl passed away from 2. You just have to think, you don't know your limit. Obviously, different drugs, different things, but you don't know your limit. Everyone's limit is different. No matter what you say, everyone's limit is different. So, and you don't know until it's too late sometimes. In some cases, like this case, you don't know until it's too late. And I just hope that this is a lesson, you know, for places to up their security. Check the bags properly, look in the bags, pour our bags out on the table, because this is fun, but I don't think there's anything fun about dying from one pill, or two pills. It's just really, really sad event. The meeting got cancelled today because of it, because there was too many drugs, couldn't deal with it. And it's really, really sad that it got to that point. I don't know if I'll go next year. It was a very scary environment. Everyone gurning so much that they bleed. Everyone off their heads, everyone fighting, splashing bottles on their heads. And you might be watching this and I've been to a million festivals and been thinking, Abby, that's just what happens. Wow. I've been to Victoria's twice before. And obviously it's a family festival, which is very different. It just was a scary environment. But I'm sorry to end this video on a downer, guys. My thoughts and my prayers, and they go out to the families and friends of the people who sadly passed away or were casualties, you know, from taking the pills. And I hope you guys did enjoy this video for the fun bits of it that were in it, of the music. And I had a great time. The music, you know, the music gets me high, as cringy as that sounds. Genuinely, when I was watching Afterglow. When I was watching Wilkinson and Sub Focus, it was amazing when they sang Afterglow. I was like, fuck. Not sung it, you know what I mean? Maybe their DJ shit. Wow. I was like, wow. Because I've listened to that song for years. They didn't do it in full. They did like a little remix on it. But still, just to see Wilkinson on that stage and that to be happening, I just couldn't believe it. It was amazing. And, you know, don't take pills. Just listen to a bit of Afterglow. And, yeah. I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye, guys.